morning, everyone, and welcome to the SCC Youth Film on Sunday, 2nd May. I hope you've had a good week. My mum's doing the talk today, but we are just doing the start off with my favourite worship song, The Blessing. And this is a recording of churches around the UK. I hope you enjoy it.
Second guessing, we know that we are protected. May the peace that surpasses all understanding be our message. Grace and favors in your nature, in your essence.
May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations,
and your family, and your children,
and the children, and the children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations.
Children,
may his presence go before you.
wonder if we could record an SCCU version of that. I love this song because I find it very relaxing and I feel God's presence with me. I'm going to pass over to my mum for today's talk. Thanks, mum.
Good morning, Legacy. It's been such a long time and I have missed you all so much. And I just can't wait to stand in front of you and speak to you as we used to do. This morning, I'm excited to be speaking to you about something that is very important to me. And that is about ambition as Christians. About 3 or 4 weeks ago, Jalisia asked me if I always wanted to be a teacher because I'm so good at being a teacher, maybe. But I said, no, I didn't always want to be a teacher. In fact, growing up, I wanted to be a lawyer. And I set my course on becoming a lawyer. I studied very hard. I knew the subject I needed to learn to become a lawyer. But somewhere along the line, I couldn't because of circumstances I explained to Jalisia. And what she said to me was, oh, in that case, mommy, becoming a lawyer was a dream, not an ambition for you. So I was like, okay, I have become a teacher, but I have put in so much to be a good and an outstanding teacher. But my ambition initially was to become a lawyer. So does it mean that becoming a teacher wasn't or isn't good enough? So I kind of thought about it and I said, what do we think about dreams and ambition? This morning, I'll be focusing on the Christian youth and ambition. So I looked up what ambition really is. And the Oxford Dictionary defines ambition as a strong desire to do or achieve something. Having that very strong desire to be what you want to be is what ambition really is. So there are two questions we ask ourselves as Christians as we look towards achieving our ambition. The first question is, can I strive to get to the top while still following Jesus? Can I be the best as a Christian? Can I do everything I want to do if I'm a Christian? And the answer to that question is yes, you can be everything you want to be, even as you are a Christian. Now, many people think that when you're a Christian, you cannot hit the highest target. And I looked it up and I found that actually being a Christian shouldn't stop you from achieving your ambition as far as you are focused and driven and you work so hard towards it. Now, there are so many Christians in Parliament that I think during Easter Sunday, if you watched church service, you would have seen Christians in Parliament professing Christ. Nothing has stopped them from achieving their dreams of becoming politicians. So yes, there are good politicians. And then I also looked it up and you'll be surprised at what I found, that actually there are some celebrities who are Christians that I didn't even know. For example, Mark Wahlberg. Can you believe it? He is a Christian and he actually said, let me quote what he said. He said something like, my faith and family are the most important things in my life. And those things allow me to be successful in all the other things I am doing. There's this other Christian, Chris Pratt. I love him so much. He's been a Christian since he was a teenager, just like you guys. And during one of the award ceremonies, he said, I would not be here with the ease and grace I have in my heart without my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And this is him openly professing his faith in Christ. And he is such a successful actor. And I can go on and on and on about, you know, people who have achieved their dreams and ambitions, but they are still Christians, okay? Now, many times I think the problem is that people think that becoming successful and being very ambitious is wrong, because usually we replace our success with God. So success becomes the first thing in our lives and God becomes the second thing or person in our lives. So that is where the problem of success and ambition comes. But in the parable of the talent, which is in Matthew chapter 25, verses 14 to 30. I would urge you all to read the full scripture of that. Matthew chapter 25, verse 14 to 30, the parable of the talent. In this parable, Jesus is teaching us that ambition is a good thing when we use God's gift wisely. Whatever gift we have, we need to sow it, we need to use it, we need to bring it to light, and that is to more or less give God more glory and to give him the honor that God deserves. So the talent that this passage is talking about is actually 20 years' wages of a laborer. So in that parable, it is a lot of money that this master gives to his servant as he's going away on a journey. And he says to them, use it. And when I come back, you would be accountable for it. Now, you know what happens, or if you read the chapters properly, you will know that when this master came back, two of the servant had multiplied their talent, and the master called them good and faithful servant. But the one who hadn't done anything about the talent, remember, 20 years wages, he hadn't done anything about it. The master said to him, thou wicked and slothful servant. So he took the talent that had already been given to him, gave it to the one who had five, who had multiplied it. And he said, because you have been faithful in little things, you'll be faithful in many things. Now, the Lord Jesus Christ, in the same way, has given you lots and lots of abilities, lots of things to use for his glory, for your own success and for the Lord's glory. What you need to do is to live for Jesus. No matter what you achieve, no matter the extent of your success, you need to bring God first in your ambition. To be ambitious is a good thing, but placing Christ first, placing God first, is the utmost, is the most important in our lives that we have to do. So contextually, Jesus is talking about the kingdom of heaven, what it will be like when at the end of our lives, whatever talents that we were given, what we have done with it. So whether you become a lawyer, you become a teacher, you become a nurse, a midwife, a doctor, a parliamentarian or politician or whatever that you become, what did you do with the talent that God had given you? Because you will be accountable for it. Now, as children of God, we are called to put God first. That is the most important thing. To portray him in our lives, to live our lives that is worthy and acceptable before Christ. Now, I'm going to leave you with Romans chapter 12, verse 1 and 2. It says, therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. Now, becoming ambitious and successful doesn't mean conforming to the things of this world. Be whoever you are, be a Christian. Show people that you are a Christian and you can still be a doctor. You can still be a rapper. You can still be a mechanic. You can still be whatever you want to be. God first. That is total dependence on God, because He heals, He saves, He protects, He provides. God bless you this morning, and I hope to see you very, very soon. Have a wonderful week.
Thank you for that word, Mum. I think I'd like to do astronomy when I grow up, but I'll remember to put God first in everything I do. Time for another song now. This is all about God helping us in our times of need.
Maybe midnight or midday, never early, never late, He gon' stand by what He claimed, lived enough life to save.
I heard your heart, I see your pain, out in the dark, out in the rain. Feel so alone, feel so afraid. I heard you pray in Jesus' name. It may be midnight or midday, He's never early, never late. He gon' stand by what He claimed. I lived enough life to save. Help is on the way. Sometimes it's days, sometimes it's years. Some face a lifetime of falling tears. But He's in the darkness, He's in the cold. Just like the morning, He always shows. It may be midnight or midday, He's never early, never late. He gon' stand by what He claimed. I lived enough life to save.
Time for today. So let's close up with this week's TikTok top tip. See you next week. Bye.
Yeah, that sounds good.